Hello everyone, in this video tutorial, we are going to look how to create a script for creating a pattern recognition neural network in MATLAB. So I have already written the code. Let's see what it does. So I will be creating a random matrix containing 2 rows and 1000 columns. So 1000 will be the number of samples and the first row will represent the x-axis and the second row will represent the y-axis. So what I will be doing is that dividing the space that I have created into 4 segments A, B, C and D as can be seen in the figure, and then I will be training the pattern recognition neural network with this set of data. Then I will pick any random point from these data and test the classification network that I have created for the accuracy. So this is how I created the random set of integers by using the random integer MATLAB command. Then these are some variables. Then I am using the for loop and the if statement for divided into the 4 different matrices. Do note that the constraints that I have given will lead to the overlapping of some of the data points in different subsets. And that will be good because in real life data also there is overlapping of data. So these 4 if statements divide the data I have created into 4 different matrices. Then I am creating the target matrices by giving the 4 rows and 1000 columns. One in the first row will represent that it belongs to the class A. One in the second row will represent that it belongs to class B, and so on. And then here I will be combining the different classes that I have created for both input and target. Here I create the pattern recognition neural network. So for that I have given the training function train SCG. You can also use train RP. Hidden layer size 10 neurons in the only hidden layer that I am choosing. Pattern net is the inbuilt MATLAB command for creating the pattern recognition neural network. Divide function is using divide randomly. Let the divide mode be sample. This is the training ratio, validation ratio and test ratio that I have given. Do note that we are using the cross entropy as the performance function and not the mean square error. Then I am going to train the network with the train command by providing it to the network, the input and the target. Then we calculate the output of the network by supplying it the input so as to calculate the error, and finally the performance of the network. Then we can calculate the percentage error also. Then we are recalculating the performance. This is done so that we can remove the bad data that we have in our input data set. Now after the above steps, the network has been created and also trained. So now we need to test the network. So let's use the 15% test data that the MATLAB has created by using the test indices and then providing it in the input to get the value of input at those test indices. Then these commands shows the plotting of the graphs to check the accuracy of the network visually. So let's run this code and see what happens. So after the training is complete, the window will look like this. I have already discussed all these parameters, so let's look at the receiver operating characteristic. Since the graph follows the left hand side and the area under it nearly maximum, that is 1, so it means the network is trained good and the classification accuracy is also high. Let's check the confusion plot. As you can see, for training the accuracy is 100%, for validation is 99.3% and for training it is 98%. This is the plot that I have created using the commands. So in this, the first of the vertical section is for class A, the second is for class B, third is for class C and fourth is for class D. So the line at 0.5 means that there are 50% or more than that chances that it belongs to the class A or B or C or D. So as we can see that there is one point misclassified. So it should be belonging to the class A, but it is shown not to belong to class A. It can also be seen from the confusion plot of the test division. So as you can see, it is written 1 here. Similarly, for the class B, there are 2 points. So there are 2 here. And for third, there is, for class C, there is no point. So it will be 0. And similarly for class D. Moreover, we can check the performance of the network by looking into the command window. So as you can see, then performance of the whole network is 0.0043. And we can also check performance individually from train performance, validation performance and the test performance. And in the workspace, you can see the percentage error of 0.0040. This is how we create a script for creating the pattern recognition neural network. This is just a simple example of showing how it can be used to differentiate between 4 different classes. More complex examples are available in which the use of pattern recognition application is there. and those examples will be discussed in the later videos. So that's it everyone, this is it for this video. Hope you like it and please like, subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.